Hello everybody, this is the Structures Guy, and today we're talking about the engineering of this inverted building, the Vancouver House. The Vancouver House is a 59-story mixed-used twisting tower with a height of 525 feet. The building complex will include 710,000 square feet of residential, retail, and commercial space. The tower rises from a 6,000 square feet triangular base and twists into a 14,000 square feet rectangular building. Construction of the skyscraper began in 2016 and was completed in the summer of 2020. As you can see here, the building is narrower at the bottom and gets wider as you keep going up, which is the reverse of how most skyscrapers are designed, hence earning this building a title of an inverted tower. In fact, most buildings are designed thinner at the top and wider at the bottom. So the question is, why was it designed this way? Let's watch this short clip from the principal architecture firm designer to understand the reason.
And for the tower, there's a general 30-meter setback requirement from all the bridges to ensure that nobody lives too close to the bridge, reducing our tower to this like tall, slender triangle. But also to respect the neighboring park, we had to sort of recede our silhouette to ensure that they get daylight and sunshine, reducing our footprint to only 600 square meters. But then we were thinking, if the 30-meter setback has to do with ensuring a minimum distance, as soon as we rise above and beyond the bridges, we can actually come back out and maximize the areas with the greatest views and the most abundant sunlight. So it almost becomes like this tower turned upside down that actually grows out of a tight spot in a lively city and then expands to occupy the maximum area in the surrounding skyline.
9 years after the initial contract for the building was signed in 2011, the Vancouver House stands in a grand gesture to its structural audacity and top-heavy technical feat. Attached to each of the post-tensioned reinforced concrete floor slabs, the supporting walking concrete columns follow along the curved outline of the building's northeastern edge. The offset nature of the columns shifting each floor pulls the tower floor slabs toward the bridge, aka eastward, which collects vertical gravity load of the concrete structural system and the superimposed loading. As the vertical columns gradually walk down the height of the building, they merge. Overlaying the rectangular floor onto the triangular shape below, the elevator and stair core is located off-center. The core is pushed southwest from the center of the rectangular building above. With both principles of the walking columns and the offset core, the tower is subjected to sustained lateral and torsional forces under its own gravity loading. This results in a permanent elastic lateral displacement along the height of the tower. To bring the tower design back to near verticality and account for long-term creep, Vancouver House was deliberately constructed vertically offset at each floor following directly opposite to the finally displaced shape of the tower. If constructed using a traditional central core, the elastic movement at the top of the tower would have displaced nearly 10 inches towards the east side relative to the base. Adding to the complexity of the structural design, the high seismicity of the west coast of North America compounded the challenge for the structural engineers. The summation of both gravity and seismic forces onto the system required a rigid vertical spine that is robust in resisting and stabilizing the building against both flexural and torsional loadings. At the entrance to the elevator lobby, heavy white flange beams embed 5 feet into the concrete walls at both ends directly above as you enter and exit the core, connecting the two C shapes of the core and closing it into a torsion strong box section. Rather than the traditional yielding link beams, these heavy steel sections remain elastic anti-gravity and cyclic seismic loading. The design originally called for copper or zinc to be installed where erosion occurs. However, it is so hard to get copper to look the way you want it on day 1, let alone day 100 or even 900. Designing with continuity as well as longevity in mind, the team ultimately landed on stainless steel due to the manufacturer's unique control of the finishes. The facade as a result is composed of 2mm thick stainless steel panels with a bead blasted finish. This marvelous building is not only robust in structural and architectural design, but also in sustainability and construction practices. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something from it. See you next time.